गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क. हाँ, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. सो लेट्स सी एक्सरसाइज 15.1. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. ओके, चैप्टर प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ योर इनसाइड बुक, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. ओके, अंडरस्टैंड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, एनीवन कैन रीड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. Anyone can read question number 1? Yes.
Probability of an event E plus probability of the event not E is equal to S.
Probability of an event इवेंट ई प्लस प्लस प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ द इवेंट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ द इवेंट
नॉट ई
यस. Can we say what is the value?
One.
Because probability of not E means what? It is the complementary event. Yes or no? What do you mean by complementary event? The complementary event is that the event which does not happen, which does not occur. Okay. If E is an event, if E is the occurrence of an event, then it's complementary event. The event does not happen, not occurring. Okay. So, the probability of an event plus probability of not event is 1. That is known as total probability. Okay. It means we can write probability of the event E plus probability of the event E bar. E bar indicates what? Not E. E equal to 1. Understand or not? Okay. Second question, okay, Krishna Swami, can you read question number 1, second bit? Yes, Krishna is not audible. Okay, the probability of an event, the probability of an event that cannot happen is dash. Such an event is called dash. Yes.
Impossible event.
The probability of an event that cannot happen is what kind of event?
Impossible event,
right. Is known as impossible event. Yes or no? And such an event is called? The probability of an event that cannot happen is? Probability of an event that cannot happen is 0. Yes. The probability of an event that cannot happen is 0. Yes, you're right. 0. And such an event is called impossible event. Understand or not?
Yes, sir.
It's correct. Thank you. Okay, question number third. Let's see. Okay, Rohan, read question number one or third bit.
Yes, sir. That the probability of an event that is certain to happen is dash. Sorry, sir. That the sum of the probabilities of all the elementary events of an experiment is dash.
No, this is not third bit. I'm talking third bit. The probability of an event. This is the third bit of read. Probability. Question number third bit you read. Probability of an event.
The probability of an event that is certain to happen is.
Yes.
Such an event is called as.
Yes. That is certain to happen. Is what? What is the answer? Can you tell? And certain event is called as. Okay, let me discuss first point. The probability of an event that is certain to happen is. What is the answer?
The one.
Yes, that is known as probability of C or event. Very good. The probability of C or event is 1. Certain event is said to be. It's called which event?
Certain event. C or certain event.
No, it can say your event. Okay. You write your event. All of you write. Understand or not? Okay. Okay, next question is that. Question number 1, fourth bit. The board is visible, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, read the next question. Question number 1, fourth bit. Yes?
That the sum of the probabilities of all the elementary events of an experiment is yes.
The sum of the probabilities. The sum of the probabilities, okay, of all the elementary events. Of an experiment. Each guess, what is the value? The sum of the probabilities of all the elementary events of an experiment. Yes?
One,
yes. This is the CR event, yes. Because we know that sum of all the probability of an experiment is always one. This is the, okay. The probability of E, because you see, When a coin is tossed, what is the probability of getting a head? Suppose I am explaining this one. When a coin is tossed once, okay, the probability of getting a head, what?
One by two.
Similarly, what is the probability of getting not head? Not head means what? Tail or not? Also 1 by 2. Now you see, total, what are the elementary event? Here, one is head, other is tail. Head and tail are called two elementary event. Otherwise, we also known as mutually exclusive events. We also say mutually exclusive events. Head and tail are known as mutually exclusive events or elementary events. Is it clear? So, if you add all the elementary events, so probability of head is your 1 by 2. Probability of tail is 1 by 2. If you add all the, okay. So, probability of head plus probability of tail is equal to must be one or not? Understand or not? Okay, so it is clear that the sum of all the probabilities of all the elemental events of the experiment is always one. This is one also general properties of the probability. Understood or not? Okay. Is it clear? All of you? Okay, my next question. So note down, all of you. Noted? Okay, question number one of fifth bit. Question number one of fifth bit. Can you read? Mrutunjay is there, Mrutunjay? Okay, read the question number one for fifth bit. Yes?
So the probability of an event is greater than or equal to that and less than or equal to that.
The probability of an event greater than is greater than is greater than or equal to dash. And next, what is written? And less than
or equal to dash.
Yes. Less than or equal to dash. Equal to dash. This is a very important concept. Okay, the probability of an event is greater than or equal to dash and less than or equal to dash. Students, I am explaining this one. I will explain. This is CU. And understand, we know the probability of an event, you know total number of favorable outcome by total number of possible outcome. All of you know or not? Yes or no? Total number of favorable outcome and total number of possible outcome. By here, M is the total number of favorable outcomes. Okay, the event are likely to happen. Okay. And N is the total number of possible outcome. What are the total number of? These are the mutual exclusive events. Or N indicates the elementary events in a random experiment. Okay. Total number of possible outcome are also known as elementary events or mutual exclusive events. How many events are there? While we are tossing a coin, how many events are there? One is head, other is tail. So there are two mutual exclusive events. Okay. So these are known as total number of possible outcome. Understand? And we know that what? Total number of favorable outcome always less than equal to total number of possible outcome. Yes or no? Again, another concept is that the total number of favorable outcome is also greater than equal to 0 and less than equal to n. Yes or no? This concept you know? Total number of favorable outcome may be 0 and more than 0. But always, and may be less than 1. Or may be less than n or equal to n. It means, let us divide, you are getting an inequation. 0 is less than equal to m is less than equal to n. Here we are getting an inequation. So divide and both side by n in the inequation. M by n and less than equal to n by n. Understand? So 0 by n is equal to 0. Less than equal to m by n. M by n means what? Probability of an event. Yes or no? Yes or no? So less than equal to n by n1, it means what are you getting? The probability of an event less than and or equal to what? What the value got? Tell me. The probability of an event less than or equal to, yes, less than or equal to? What you got from this?
One.
Yes. One. The probability of an event in this inequation we got. The probability of an event is less than or equal to 1. So it is given that and greater than equal to 0. So my first point is that the probability of an event is greater than or equal to what? Zero and less than equal to what?
One.
Is it clear? Understand? Okay. So question number one is over. Let us come to question number two. Note down all of you. Note down this one. Okay. This is explanation, not explaining, explanation. Is it clear? Okay. Come to the next point, next question. Question number two, anyone? Will you please read question number two? Question number two. Yes, question number two.
Which of the following experiments have equally likely outcomes?
Yes. You have to find out what number one is given, a driver. A driver, first one, driver attends. Please read the question. Driver attends to start a car. Driver attempts to start a car. The car starts or does not start? The car starts or does not start? Is the question or not? Is it a random experiment? The question is asking, and which of the following experiments are equally likely outcome? The events are equally likely outcomes are known as random experiment. What do you mean by equally likely outcomes? Yes. The experiment have equally likely outcomes. What do you mean by that? The experiment whose result is uncertain, whose result cannot be predicted with certainty, with surety, they are known as equally likely outcome. Another most important factor that, okay, and there is no partiality. The decision is neutral. The event, the outcome of an experiment is always neutral. Understand? Okay. Is it clear? And such kind of events are known as the experiment are equally likely outcome. Equally likely outcome means, what I mean? The result, the outcome of an event, the outcome of an experiment is cannot be predicted. Cannot be predicted with certainty and the outcome is neutral, impartial. There is no partiality. Such kind of events are known as are equally likely outcome. Is it clear? Is it clear all of you? Okay. Here is a question. A driver attempts to start a car. The car starts or does not start. Do you think is it an experiment of equally likely outcome? The car will start. A car starts or does not start? Do you think this is an experiment which is an equally likely outcome, or we other word we say random experiment. What is random experiment? I told now the experiment or equally likely outcome. Okay, the outcome, this is an experiment where the result cannot be predicted with certainty, but the outcome will be one of the possible events. Okay. And without any partiality. Okay, it is neutral. Nobody. Understand or not? So the driver, a driver attempts to start a car. The car starts or does not start. What kind of event? Is it an equally likely outcome? Do you think?
No.
It is not a random experiment. Because? No. What is the answer then? It is not an equally likely outcome. The experiment is not an equally likely outcome. It is not an equally likely outcome. Why? It means this is not a random experiment. It means it is not a random experiment. This experiment is not a random experiment. Why? Why? Why it is not a random experiment? Because the driver knows whether the car starts or not. Because the driver is sure. Because the driver is sure. Is sure. And is certain. And is certain. Whether the car starts or does not start. Whether the car starts or does not start. This is the reason. This is the reason. Okay. Or does not start. Yes or no? Does not start. Is it clear? The driver is certain. Driver is okay because being a driver, he knows whether the car can start or cannot start. He knows. So it cannot be. So this is an outcome, is not a random experiment. The event is sure. Okay. That's, understand? This is not an uncertain event. This is not an uncertain event. This is a certain event. Because the driver is clear and whether his car will start or will not start. Is it clear? So it cannot be a random experiment. So the events are not equally likely outcome. Is it clear, students? Okay. Okay, my next question. And question number 2, let's see. Question number 2, the second weight. So can you read question number 2, the second weight? Yes. Note down all of you. Yes. Yes. Anyone read? The player attempts to shoot a basketball. Do you think it is an equally likely outcome? Equally likely outcomes. This is an experiment. She or he shoots or misses the shot. Is it a random experiment? Do you think? Is it a random experiment? Equally likely outcome is a random experiment. Those events whose outcome cannot be predicted with certainty or surety. Is it clear? So, a player attempts to shoot a basketball. She or he shoots or misses the shot. Is it a random experiment? Can you tell me? No, it is not a random experiment. It is not a random experiment. Why? Experiment. Because the player is certain. Because the player because the player has surety. The player has surety. P-L-E-A-R. Player has surety. Surety was certainty. C-R-T-A-I-N-N-T-Y. Certainty. Whether he or she can shoot or not. Yes or no? Shoot or not. So this event is sure. Understand? So this is not an equally likely outcome. So this experiment is not an equally likely outcome. Equally likely outcome. Understand? Is it clear? Yes? Note down. Okay, so what is my question number 2, third bit? What is the next bit? Question number 2 or third bit? Let's see. Yes? Question number 2 or third bit? Let us read. Yes? A trial is made. A trial is made to answer a true false question. True false question. This is one of the experiment. Okay. And the answer is right or wrong. Do you think? Is it a random experiment?
Yes, sir.
How do you think? Yes. What is that? Yes. It is a random experiment. Yes or no? Why? Or it is an experiment or equally likely outcome? It is a random experiment and equally likely outcome. Why? Can you tell me? Because the event is, the outcome is uncertain. Because the outcome or result is uncertain. Is it clear? And cannot be predicted. Predicted with certainty. Is it clear? Understand? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then question number 2 of 4th bit. Let us write, it tells you write this explanation. You write this. Because this is the appropriate region. Ignore your answer. That is very most important part. So next question. Question number 2 of 4 page. Let's see. Question number 2 of 4 page. A baby is born. It is a boy or a girl. Yes? Do you think is it a random experiment? Yes or no? What do you think? It is a random experiment. Yes or no? Because the yes, right? Yes, it is a random experiment. It is a random experiment. And is an equally likely outcome. Outcome, what is the reason? Because the outcome is not sure. Because the outcome is not sure and cannot be predicted. Cannot be predicted with certainty, right? So this is not an equally likely outcome. Equally likely outcome. Whenever any reasoning question, you have to give the appropriate reason, okay, logic behind your answer. Nowadays, your answer should not be yes or no. Because case study questions are there also, you have to write the reason, appropriate reason, students, in the MCQ. Why it is the right answer for you? So, to give the appropriate reason, suitable reason against your answer. Okay, the question number 2 is over. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, no doubt. Let's move question number 3. Question number 3. Okay, question number 3. Anyone? Will you please read question number 3? Don't read question number 3. Sagar is there?
Yes, sir.
Read anyone, read. Oh, only the why the they are very less in number? I don't know. What is the reason? Okay, read question number 3.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
The why is tossing a coin considered to be a fair way of deciding which team should get the ball at the beginning of a football game?
Let me write. Why is Why is tossing a coin considered to be a fair way? Fair means what? What do you mean by fair? Fair way of deciding which team should get the ball. At the beginning. At the beginning of a football game. a football game. Understand this question? Okay. So, why is tossing a coin considered to be a fair way of deciding which team should get the ball at the beginning of a football game? Before football game is going to start, there is a toss. Okay. And tossing a coin considered to be a fair way. What is the meaning of fair way? Fair way means what? What is the meaning of fair way? Yes? Fair means what? Neutral. Fair means neutral. Okay. Okay, no bias, unbiased, we can say. Neutral, impartial. Impartial, understand or not? Huh? What is the meaning impartial? Impartial means what? No discriminations. Okay, no partiality. Or unbiased, we can say unbiased. So many words you can use for the random experiment. Okay, unbiased, fair way, neutral. Okay. Does George give the right decision or not? So he is in neutral, he is impartial, yes or no? In the court, he is neutral, impartial, unbiased. Similarly, tossing a coin is considered a fair coin, fair way of deciding when the team, which team should get the ball. Why? What is the reason? Because the tossing a coin, is considered to be a fair way of deciding. Of deciding which team, should get the ball at first. Because what is the reason? Because the tossing a coin is a random experiment. So it is because tossing a coin is a random experiment, whose outcome cannot be predicted, no prediction. Prediction means what? Happening in the future. What will happen in your future to your life? It's a kind of prediction. What will happen to your result in class 10 board exam? That's a kind of prediction. Are you sure over that? No surety. Okay. So that is known as the prediction. Whose outcome cannot be predicted with certainty. Okay, is it clear or not doubt? So this experiment, that is why the tossing a coin is considered to be a fair way, means unbiased. It is unbiased, neutral, impartial. Okay, and no team will complain that which team will get the ball first. Yes or no? Is it clear? No doubt. Is there any doubt, students? Over. Okay, come to the next question number थ्री जो है क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, लेट्स सी क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर। Anyone will read question number 4? Yes? No one. Which of the following? Am I audible, all of you? Which of the following cannot be? Cannot be the probability of an event. Cannot be the probability of an event. First one, fast speed is given. There are four options are given, 2/3. Understood or not? Yes or no? So can you take the probability of an event can be 2/3? Can be 2/3, do you think? Yes, tell me, what do you know? Tell. Huh? The probability of an event can be 2/3. Is it right to say? Yes or no? Because you know the probability of an event. Because we know. The probability of an event, just I told now, the probability of an event is always less than equal to 1 and greater than equal to 0. It means that any number, the probability of an event is less than, lies between 0 and 1. It means the probability of an event is always a proper fraction. Any fraction lies between 0 and 1 is a proper fraction. Yes or no? Since 2 is less than 3, so I can say 2/3 is less than 3/3. So that implies 2/3 is less than 1. It means the probability of an event is 1, less than 1. Yes or no? Yes or no? Thus it can be, thus probability 2/3 can be the probability of an event. 2/3 can be the probability of an event. Can be the probability of an event. Okay, understand? Okay. So second point is that because you understand every proper fraction can be the probability of an event. Note down these properties. Every proper fraction. Note down students. Every proper fraction, one of the property. Every proper fraction always less than 1 is always less than 1, yes or no? Is always less than 1 and hence can be the probability of an event. Note down. Probability of an event. Yes or no? But improper fraction, because the improper fraction is greater than 1, so any improper fraction cannot be the probability of an event. And the probability of an improper fraction is always 0. It is an impossible event. Is it clear? Yes? Note down this one. Okay. Second point is that option B. What is option B given? There are four options given. Let us write first option. A is 2/3. Option B is -1.5. And option C is 15%. And option D is 0.7. Understand? Okay, let's see option B. Let us take option B. Option B is -1.5. You see the -1.5, which is what kind of number? it is a negative rational number. It is a negative decimal number. So any negative decimal number cannot be the probability of an event, because we know that the probability of an event is always lies between 0 and 1 and is never negative. Understand? So minus 1.5 cannot be the probability of an event. Am I audible, students, all of you? Yes or no, students? Yes? So cannot be the probability of an event. Why? Because the probability of an event is never negative. Because the probability of an event is never negative. Is never negative. Is it clear? Clear? Yes? Am I listening? Am I able to audible, students?
Yes, sir.
See? Yes, sir. So, Priti Pragya, are you able to understand? Pragya Paramita? Pratyush? Pratyush, are you writing?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, okay, next point C. The point C is telling, third point, C is 15%. 15% is equal to, how can I, 15 by 100 or not? So, it is a proper fraction and its value less than 1. Yes or no? Since 15 by 100 is less than 1, so 15% can be the probability of an event. Probability of an event. Because we know the probability of an event is always is less than 1. Can be less than 1? Because we know that the probability of an event can be less than 1. Can be less than 1. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes? So, another point, or the last point. The point is 0.7. 0.7. No doubt. So, 15% can be the probability of an event. It's possible. Okay. And point D, you see. Point D, what is saying? 0.7. Okay, 0.7 means what? 7 upon 10. And its value less than 1. So, since 7 by 10 is less than 1. So, it is the probability of an event. So only which option is the correct option? Which of the correct option? Out of 4, which is the correct option? Option B. Option B, which is minus 1.5, and thus the option B is the correct option. Thus, the option B minus 1.5 is the correct option. Understand? Okay, it's clear. Shall we move question number 5? Okay, thank you, students. Already it is the time to depart. Okay, thank you, all of you.
Thank you,
and try for the remaining answer. Okay, thank you once again, all of you.